Hello, Anishay. How have you been doing now? I haven't been doing a video in a while, and the reason is quite simply, I was busy. I'm extremely busy nowadays. A lot of it has to do with witchcraft and paganism and running my Ile coven. Ile is a house in Voodoo, in Yoruba language, and I'm the queen. I'm the voodoo queen of that house. As you see, the queen is not about sex. It's more about basically the job that you do, the job that you do. So, I'm doing my voodoo queening and I'm extremely busy, but I will take the time to do a witchy book haul. Now, those are books that I have assembled in the last year. I got them from various places, thrift books, the book depository. I also got some, and I will show you these in like Israeli thrift books stores. And I can show you them and I tell you what I got. And a lot of them are academic books that are basically not like Witchcraft 101 books, but the advanced practitioner should take them into consideration. Okay, so the first pile that I see, I got these modern witchcraft spell books. And I see that these are very popular, they are hardcover, and they have a lot of interesting ideas. Spells for loves and friendship, money and abundance spells, spells for safety and protection, spells for personal professional success, health and healing spells. That's interesting for me. Lately, I'm very much interested in health and healing spells. Spells for self-improvement, spells to do with others, seasonal spells and magical recipes, miscellaneous spells, taking the next step, and metric conversion charts and index. So, this is very Tumblr sort of new thing, and I like to get myself acquainted with the new books. Practical Celtic Magic by Murray Hope. Now, not a lot survived from the Celtic tradition magically, at least not enough that one could call that an entire magical system. And I'm very interested also to see how people interpreted what did survive and used it. So I'm using it right now. Another one that I got from thrift books is The Devil: Perception of Evil from Antiquity to Primitive Christianity by Jeffrey Russell. I think he's the same writer that wrote the History of Witchcraft. Oh, this one I got in the book Depository: Witchcraft, A Guide to Ingredients. It's a small little pamphlet. I like having those. You always find like one or two things that you didn't know from other books. Also, it cost less than $5 plus shipping, so I got it. I got Lucy Mayer, Witchcraft, which is an academic book, which is like, why should there be witches? What are witches like? Protection against witches, the detection of witches, suspension and accusation, witchcraft and Lysian fishing, the treatments of witches, new ways to deal with witches, fantasy and reality in witch trials, theories of witchcraft, and witchcraft in a Christian context. No bibliography. And this is very much an academic book. It's an academic book. It has a bibliography. It has, side notes and whatever. So, it's very interesting to see like an anthology like that deals with different subjects of witchcraft. This one is a rare one nowadays. It's like all the tarot style books today are difficult to find, but I found this. The Witch's Formulary and Spellbook by Tower Star, and I was willing to get that for a long time, and it was expensive. It was expensive. And I haven't gone through it yet, but I'm dying to see what's going on. What does it have? Celtic Witchcraft. Modern Witchcraft and Celtic Ways by Pagan Portals by Mab Savage. Again, I'm dying to know what they're saying about Celtic witchcraft. I haven't seen too much that was really out there and interesting, but I will find out. Okay. Love Magic by Laurie Cabot. And I did a lot of book reviews about Laurie Cabot. This one is also with Tom Cowan, which is an unfortunate name when you are neo-pagan because it's very similar to Cowan, like a non-witch. And I love the power of the witch. The The Power of the Witch is by far my favorite book by Laurie Capote. If you're considering to get just one, get The Power of the Witch. Now that I have this, the only one that I'm missing is The Science of the Craft, and then I would have everything that they have written. Taste from the Temple, Kitchen Witchery from the Temple of Witchcraft by Dawn Hunt. And it's followed by Christopher Penzack. It's another one from the Laurie Cabot tradition. And I love recipe books. I love witchcraft books that are like about recipe and cooking, because I do a lot of cooking in my life, basically. The Modern Guide for Witchcraft, Witches, Covens, and Spells. It also has like, I really want like to know what people are saying about how different traditions, most of them are getting from Wicca, but not necessarily, how different traditions are like, you know, raising their babies and having like new traditions being made, you know, if there is a Klingon Wicca, probably there is Klingon Wicca, etc., etc. Anyway, that's one pile. There are three more left. It's a big book haul. Icelandic Magic by Stefan E. Flowers. And I was hesitant to get that because basically Stefan E. Flowers, he wrote Hermetic Magic and it was a bunch of shit. So maybe he had more interesting to say about Icelandic magic. I got this. And I got this academic book about Icelandic magic because now I have all the grimoires, the Icelandic grimoires that were translated into English. And they're very problematic precisely because the grimoire comes without instructions. It's just the spells. But you have to have preliminary rituals and things that you do before you cast the spells, or else you have no right to do them properly. And it will fuck you up. So you need to know whatever you can about a genre of magic before you use it. I also got Terje's Parkland Norwegian Runes and Runic Inscriptions. And you'll find that they have a lot of books nowadays about runes and runic magic. That's because there is an Asatrua tribe nearby crystallizing around me, and I thought it would be very important to have all the books that they might need in case that they need to study their sort of magic. So even though I'm located in the other end of Israel for them, I think it would be very good that they have, like, you know, a nice bookshelf about Norwegian magic and like Icelandic magic and runic magic and stav magic in my library. Another one that I got is Runes and Runic Inscriptions that also like stem out into Anglo-Saxon magic. A friend of mine ordered this, I thought it was good. It's an academic book, by the way. So I got myself a copy as well. I got another academic classic, which is Magic, Witchcraft and Curing, edited by John Middleton. And it's another one of those books that stemmed after On Purity and Danger by, what was her name? It was a very important academic book that reaffirmed magic. I don't quite recall the name of the author, but like every academic person that ever wrote about witchcraft and is talking about like contemporary, feminist, and anthropological essence of it should read it. If it's so important, tell me and I'll find what her name was. Mary Douglas. Her name was Mary Douglas. I got this Magical Spell for Your Home by Anne Marie Gallagher. And the thing is about her books, it's like, I wouldn't call them very magical accurate, but she has that one thing that might make the shit work in there. But she makes wonderful inspiration and like, you know, hardcover and beautiful books that makes you want to have a garden just like that. So it springs you into action. And you know, it's mostly all white magic. Like honey sandwich spells, staying friends with your neighbors, for instance. If you have neighbors you need to be friends with. I got the second expanded edition of The Magical Formulary by Herman Slater. There needs to be a reprint of these. It's just, you know, they are too important not to be reprinted. Yes, other books gave their own version of, you know, those classic hoodoo formulas, but first of all, not a single book has all of them. And second, you know, you need to have like several version of a condition formula to understand what they wanted. You need the proper reference book to go with what it does medicinally and how this implies the spirit world and how you're building, rebuilding that formula with what's available to you, or else it's not really hoodoo. It's more like this plasticine, hoodoo-esque sort of thing. Also got this in thrift books, the Encyclopedia of Modern Witchcraft and Neo-Paganism. I love having a lot of reference books. Like, here, I open it, self-blessing. Self-blessing may be done anytime as a pagan wishes to affirm her connections with the gods within. You mean daily observances? It's important, daily observances. Another used book like that is like Witchcraft in America, which is again, it's an academic book that has, it's an anthology that has several articles by the same authors, you know, about witch trials and hanging on Gallows Hill, and if you're interested in the witch, if you're interested with a more academic approach to the Salem witch trial, this is where it is. Okay, so that's two piles, two left. We're just halfway through. Be patient. Okay, these I got in like my search in used bookstores in Jerusalem. That, I don't know if you heard, but now it's the capital city of Israel. It just said that in most encyclopedias and books around the world, but apparently that was like an egregious news. Okay, Questions on Occultism by Ernest Wood. And this is a book written by people in theosophy. And it has like what theosophy is, what is meditation, reincarnation, karma, evolution, yoga, Hinduism, Buddhism, Zen, Christianity, men, space, time, law, symbolism, death, senses, and miscellaneous. So, you know, it's like really answering the occult side of things. And I think that, you know, me as a witchcraft teacher, I could enrich what I teach through materials from that book. Crystal ball gazing. I never have enough divination books, and this cost nothing. So it's a used book. And I have some scrying books, and you can join them. Okay. Rituals and Medicines. Indigenous Healing in South Africa. And, you know, African magic, I'm taking it. I'm taking African magic every time I find them. Rock Crystal, the Magic Stone. It's a book about quartz. There is not enough in writing about quartz. More people should be using like the clear quartz for all sorts of things. Cosmic Crystal, Crystal Consciousness and the New Age by Ra Bonowitz. And I wonder if it's related to Isaac Bonowitz. You know, in all those healing crystal books, you always find, oh, this one actually has a thing in there. This one has like, you know, different what crystal can do in heal, but every once in a while you find a property that you didn't know about the crystals that you're using, and you can use that to make a very precise talisman spell, something about this specific formulation of quartz, this specific formulation of amethyst, how they were used in ancient cultures and whatever. You can never have enough crystal books. And another one, Fortune Telling by Crystals and Semi-Precious Stones, a practical guide for the use in divination, meditation, and healing by Ursula Markham. And I wonder when this was printed. It looks quite old. 1987. It was the 80s were the heyday of crystal healing, if you ask me. Not the 60s, the 80s. The Talisman Magic Workbook by Kala and Ketz Pagion. And apparently, you know, all of those of you that likes Janet Ferrer and Stuart Ferrer, they are very much, they believed in this book. They loved this book, and it's now sadly out of print. Maybe because it's not from Llewellyn. And it was printed in 1992. Another little thing I'm very proud of getting, A Guide to Mexican Witchcraft. You know, a lot of people are talking about Mexican witchcraft, but most of the books about Mexican witchcraft that are not like very, very, very specific are simply are in, you know, Espanol. And if you're not reading over Espanol, for instance, in Israel, you know, we learn Arabic, we learn English. English is like our second language. We learn Arabic, we learn, you know, we might even learn French language, but we never learn any of the Spanish languages at school. So it's like either you pick it up later, or, you know, you get it from home, but it's a problem for Israeli people. I understand that in the US, like, you know, speaking all those Spanish languages are like the second language that they study, but in Israel you will find almost none of that. Runic Inscriptions in Great Britain by Paul Johnson. That's a cute little pamphlet that I've gotten that has like black and white pictures that are simply gorgeous, and of course their meaning. I finished buying all the Living Temple of Witchcraft, all the Temple of Witchcraft books, The Journey of the Gods. So I have this one, and I have The Journey of the Goddess too. Another academic book that, you know, charm makers and amulet makers might consider is Runic Amulets and Magic Objects. And it's an anthology, it's an academic anthology. Let me tell you the chapters in it. It's very, very juicy, and it's not a cheap book. Like most academic, and it's a hardcover, and like most academic books, it's not a cheap book. It cost me like $75. Okay. Introduction, the principal runic alphabets, names of runes, gods and heroes, love, fidelity and desire, protective and enabling charms, fidelity charms, healing charms and leechcraft, pagan ritual items, Christian amulets, rune stones, death and curses, runic lore and other magic. Sorry, and conclusion. So if you're looking to make like magical items like the ancient did, and if you have affinity for the runes because you're on a Saturar or Teodeshik, or, you know, or you practice any of the British indigenous faiths, get this. And I'm planning to read this, and I'm planning to do a full book review for you guys. Okay. Also got a hardcover of Magic, Theory and Practice by Aleister Crowley. You know, any printed books of Aleister Crowley from this day and age, and you see it's a vintage one, are quite expensive. This one was printed by 1991 and starts with the Heim to Pan. Okay, one last pile and we are done. Okay. Potions, Herbs, Oil and Brews, The Ultimate Reference Learning Guide for Wiccans and Herbalists Alike by Christina Benson. Also a very interesting one, and one that is not commonly known. I like the not commonly known things. Banishing Oil, 1/2 ounce apricot kernel oil, 7 drops pepper oil or a pinch of pepper, 10 drops peppermint oil, 12 drops rue or rosemary oil, handful of pine needles, a bundle of dried sage, 1 black onyx stone. Simply mix the ingredients and strain out the herbs after a week. Do not anoint yourself with this oil, as it's very strong and you don't want to banish yourself, nor do you now. Use it to sprinkle on space on surface. As you do it, focus on the person and energy you wish to banish. Yeah, it's actually pretty solid. It's pretty solid the way I see it. So, you know, if you're looking for another potion book, you know, you might consider this one. Balkan Traditional Witchcraft by Radomir Ristik, translated by Michael C. Carter Jr. Now, honestly, I'm not so much into Balkan witchcraft, but this book was recommended everywhere. So I had to get it. It was on sale, so I just got it from the book depository. Free Jacobean Witchcraft Plays. Sophonisba, the witch of Endemonton. The Jacobean England, you know, it was like, you know, it was a period in time of England. And I don't think there are enough plays about witchcraft, and I would like to read them and see if any of those should be resurrected nowadays. I'm actually, my first degree is in theater studies, if you didn't know. Okay, I also got myself a storybook. It's called A Diary of a Witchcraft Shop, of a Magic Shop. And I like to read about stuff like that, you know, little snippets of literature. They are fascinating. That's the second Living Temple of Witchcraft, The Journey of the Goddess, The Descent of the Goddess by Christopher Pinzak. I also, you know, I'm also have like a second degree Reiki. So this is the magic of Reiki. I want to see what he has to say about that, about the magic of Reiki. I actually doubt that he has anything relevant to say. His book, Instant Magic, if you heard my review, was very, very bad. And the Oxford Illustrated History of Witchcraft and Magic by Owen Davids. Again, it's another book picture that, you know, first of all, the history of witchcraft is a very, very important thing. And having a book that with pictures gives you, like, you know, understanding sometimes more than, you know, any other thing. It's like witches working weather magic from Ulrich Molitor de Lamis in 1489 is the first published pictures of witches using a cauldron. Did you know that? Now this book is, this thing is everywhere, but now you know where it's from. So the history is very important. So those, my dear, are the books that I got in the last, I think, like half a year, like 6 months of books. Some of them were very cheap, some of them were more expensive, but you know, this is what I'm saving all my money for. Do you have did any of those books interest you? Would you purchase any? Please tell me if you would, and tell me why. And also, if you like this video, please like and subscribe. I would love to see you on my channel, and I have some more videos to do, and maybe I'll do them today, I don't know. So, goodbye, Nashia, my lovelies, and please have a pleasant new year.